first guest to be summoned, a Naidaya, was to be found in the darkest depths of the Kaldipo caves. For a spirit to leave her domain, though, was no simple task.
Ah! Lucy was barely containing her excitement as Margaret continued to train her patiently. When will be the time? When? She kept asking. To the excitable and talented child, few chores were as boring as practice. But the fire child still needed more. Compensation bestowed by the gods.
Yeah.
Grandma was already there, as always, before the Bergson could have a look around. Those who approach the light will gain more valuable experiences, was how the tablet was explained. Something more sinister will be appearing soon. Had they only been quicker. Of being called Shady, he instead adopted the title Mysterious Shopkeep. Welcome, friend, the shopkeep greeted. Don't mind the occasional bloodstain on the merchandise. Creature of inanimate stone, given life by the power of the mountain god and presented to the mother of beasts. Grandma knew they needed to get past it to get to Mayor Dyer's halls to discover more about the connection between the god and the corruption.
Come on.
Lucy was trying to convince Grandma that she could face the corruption on her own, despite having doubts herself. She might be able to persuade Margaret, but Mary was another story. Grandma would say, "Trust the children," and convince Mary. But Lucy knew that her mother would still worry. Everybody was worried about Anaya Dyer's stone sentinel that they would probably have to face on their quest. "Can fire even harm stone?" Lucy asked intently. Kevin was having similar thoughts about the alloy Uncle Ben had used to forge his daggers. The time had come at last. She could finally fight real enemies. Afraid but excited, the younger daughter of the Bergsons wondered if she would pass this test. Thank you. I did it. I did it, said Lucy when she met Grandma. Margaret's proud smile signaled the end of Lucy's training. She now had to return home to tell her mother and hopefully put some of her worries to rest. Object of power, ready to be unleashed. And now the Fire Child was ready. Heroes from stories were often above mundane daily tasks, but not all heroes made time to eat around the same table, talk of affairs other than war and looming shadows.